between those SDK. So every class, we need waste some time to install the Android SDK. So it's a reason why we made the local LAN to save this problem. In some place, there is no internet. You can see the project now. If you don't have internet, you must use the local name. In some place, there is internet, but you cannot send Google. You may hear about the Great Firewall of China. Yeah. Well, we can see many Chinese people, so you cannot how to access Google. If you cannot access Google, how could you download the Android Studio? How could you install the SDK? It's no difference with no internet. So you can see how important the LAN mirror important. Some people will laugh. From our country, we have internet, have Google, so we didn't need your LAN mirror. I want to ask you, can you access Google in your country? Yes. What in your can access Google, but you may think you are a lucky dog. Yeah, you don't speak Chinese. Well, terrible. Yeah, but however, Chinese said the winner is not at in the end. Let me see how much of us could love and aim. In some place, there is both internet and can Google. But if there are too many students, for example, study jam, that needs to have 50 students. And even if you want to run study jam in this session, maybe 100 people are in IO. 5,000 people. How could you make sure your internet is very well and capable? Everybody could access Google very fast. I think you cannot make proof. So in this case, you still need the local error mirror for your Android developer. So I think you have learned about why we do it. If you think this topic is helpful, please vote for us. I know most people have voted for us. So I can stand here to present for you. However, if you are continue vote for us, we can know how important it is, and we can get more support from this project and encourage more people join this project. Hope you make the development environment better. Thank you very much. Okay. Let us continue. I will talk about the requirements of this project. At first, you need a Git name. For the Windows user, you need a CVGV. And you also need wget. You also can use CVGV on your Windows. And Java, HTTP server. This is what you need for this project. At first, to keep this project is be simple. We assume that you use the same setting like us. We assume that you store your file for SDK in this directory. And your host is at base, and your IP and your pad your port is same as us. However, you can change this if you are like. But then you need to keep it consistent. You can rewrite all settings to your port, to your host, to your port. Before I start the next class, I will introduce this, our partner, Frank. Frank is the real man red code to make the logo area here. However, he has two kids now. He has a very happy family. And they have a lot of stand here to share with us. It's our first technique, but we think we should glad because he has a good family. We need to help him. So at first, we want to thank for Frank to this project. Then I will show you how to set up your mirror and the server. At first, this slide I will send to you later. If you need your name and email, I will send it to you. So you can just know about how we build it to make it clean. And for the details, we can discuss later. I will give some time to demo it. So you just follow me, it's enough. At first, you need to move the director which you want to store your file. And the git clone from save and download your script. This script will help you download the Android developer, Android Studio, and SDK manager. After that, you need to run this script, download.sh, to download your Studio and SDK. When the downloading is finished, you can start your service. For the Linux user, you should use sudo. For the Windows user, if you use savengmin, you don't need to use sudo. Let's talk about what in the script. The script includes the index HTML. It will download the Nested Android Studio and SDK manager. It will store in DL block, and it also includes package.csv. It will show which the name of SDK package and where you can download it. In addition, there was some SDK for the glass and so on. Yeah, it's what the index do. It downloads the Nested as Android Studio. Now, I assume that you download your mirror card file. Then, I will talk about how to set your connect. You should do three steps. The first is in the SDK manager, force your HTTPS to true. I will show you. Go so here, option, click this, force HTTPS to HTTP. Then you should disable your official repositories. The official repository, you should disable the all. Disable. And then you should add the hero of us. This is our consumer's site. You can see. Here is studygen.dosu.hu. It's our website. We download from this website instead of download from Google. Make the user don't need to do anything hands-on. You don't need to use the SDK manager of the setting. We just read some script to help you auto set it. So we read a CFT file. This file want to change all this Google set to our set. In offline, we want to run three CFG files to make the three steps by matching. Not need to do anything. However, it sounds good, but there is a problem. You can see in this XML, this set is hard code, so we cannot directly change it to our website. So this file and this file is not work. We cannot change the set, so this repository is not work. If it is not work, how could we disable the original site and how to use the consumer site? So we cannot do it. dl.google.com also have other files you need to download. So we cannot change it. To save this problem, we don't use CFG file. We just change our host. For example, we change the host of Google to our local set. We cannot do these two sets. We just do the first and then change the host. So when the project finished, it looks like this. So I very slightly to hope the Android team help us to change it, fix it. Don't use the hard code. Please let us to set it. It will make it simple. I'm not good at joke. However, for software engineer, I think find the bug also is very interesting. It's a joke. Wow. Let us see what will happen in the SDK manager. Like this, if you is a Linux user, you can install the Windows SDK packages. This Google USB driver is only work in Windows. However, the Linux user could install it. You can install it, but after that, you cannot delete it. So, it's very strange. I think you can download it and install it. It's okay. But you cannot delete it. It's not okay. It's very strange. So I think the team just like want you make a mistake and don't give any chance to fix your mistake. Just like you think a good, the bad man. And for other interesting things, if you want to download, delete the SDK package here, it will show this. However, it's not a school bar here. It's now you didn't find any mistake. You can click yes to delete all of this. However, if some guys feel I'm nothing to do, I installed all SDK package and I delete all SDK package. Something funny will happen. This may be too long, and there is no scroll bar. So you can say, whoa, there is no button. I cannot click it. So how could I do? Close the SDK manager, close the computer, restart. That's interesting. And if you use the SDK manager, you know how important the Android SDK tools important here. It should not be deleted. If you delete this, you cannot use SDK manager anymore. However, it is along your delete. It's just like I can pick me up and throw me out. How could you do it? If you feel funny, you can try it. But for me, I will not try it for at all. So, after a joke, I will come back. I really want the Android team to make the setting configurable. We really want to use all sides to reflect the hardware setting. Now, we talk about something out of the LAN mirror. In some times, there is no LAN mirror. For example, you just want to download a package. You don't want to install all package. So at this time, you need to build a LAN mirror. You just want to download and install one page. So install all mirror is with time. So we need a way to make me sure in any place I can install any package very quickly. In all LAN mirror, we will not include all SDK package. So if some package is not included in our mirror, you also should have some way to download. So we add other solution. For this part, you'll need a web manager. In this case, it's SDK manager and a proxy and a term file. I will show you how the SDK manager installs the file. For example, if I want to install this file, the SDK manager will check whether this file in the term flaw. I will save the term flaw. So I can show you. No, I didn't install the sample for SDK. Then I declined to initialize. You still can install it. No, you can see the internet is disconnected.
Website of us.
Ah, so now what's the one?
left side is red and use polymer. This website, you can choose some SDK you want to download. And you will get the website URL. And you can directly download it. You may think it's useless because it's the Google's set. However, if you pick it to the proxy, the proxy will check the file in their server. If their server have this package, he will not download this package from Google. He will download the package from his own website. It will make the download more quickly. This project we also put on GitHub. You can fork it and help us improve it. So, at last, well, thanks for all people created from it. Me and Frank. And we also thanks for Ru. He ran this website of Polymer and help us very quick to set the website as you just saw. And I also thank everybody behind of us. GE Suzhou, GE China, and the Global Developer Group. Thank you all. And also thanks the open source world, and also thank all those who vote for this topic. Thank you.